Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how you can add query string parameters onto your API gateway functions. So in the last video, which will be linked in the description, we created a Lambda function that simply returns a random number between 1 and 100. Now we're going to be extending this functionality to be able to tell our Lambda function what the minimum and maximum range should be for that random number within the URL parameters. So if we go over to our code, I'm going to copy the code from the last video. This can be found in a GitHub repository in the description. If I copy this and we go into the folder here for the second video, we can run npm init-y and we can make a new file, index.js, and we can paste this in here. We're then going to copy the test script, which will also be found in the description, and we're going to paste that inside of the new package JSON. And we're going to make sure everything works. So we're going to run npm run test, and we see a random number. So everything seems to be working. Now what I want to do is I want this event parameter to contain a minimum and a maximum integer for what the boundary should be for the random number. So we can simply destructure this, and then we can instead of saying plus one, we're going to say plus min. And then inside here, we're going to have other parentheses, max minus minimum plus one. This is how you're going to be able to generate a random number between two different boundaries. If we save this file and then we go into our package JSON and we add in some test things, such as a minimum is 10 and maximum is 15. If we save this and we run it, we see 15 and 13 and 10 and everything in between. So this seems to be working here. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that when the query string parameters are passed in from AWS API Gateway, they're going to be in the string format. So we actually want to turn these into numbers, and we can do that by simply putting a plus sign in before them. However, that doesn't look too good. So what I want to do is I want to say const minimum equals plus event.min, and then const maximum equals plus event.max. That way we're only doing it once and not for these three places here. So if we save this, everything should still work like normal. Okay, cool. Now what we're going to do is we're going to go into our Lambda function that we created in the last video, and we're going to simply copy this code into the inline editor. And the reason we can do this is because we have no third-party dependencies. So if we control S to save in the inline editor, we click on save at the top right, we could then go into our test function, and we see minimum is 10,000, maximum is 100,000. And if we click on test, we get 11,000 and then 92,000. And we keep going and we see that this is generating a random number with between those boundaries. So now going into API Gateway, we're actually going to configure this to accept URL parameters to then be passed into our Lambda function. If we go to method request and we go to URL query string parameters, we can click on add query string. We're going to say minimum. We're going to click on the check mark. We then want to click on the required option here, because in our code, we don't actually check for if minimum exists or add any defaults to it or anything like that. So we're simply going to just require on the API level. Of course, you can set this to be optional and you can add in your own logic into your Lambda function. However, I'm going to choose this option. We get this warning right here. It's essentially saying that we have to, under the request validator, we have to go ahead and validate the query string parameters in some way. I prefer to use the middle option here, because if I add things in the future to this, I don't have to worry about validating the other parts as well. So we're going to click on the check mark, and now we're going to add a maximum parameter. We're going to set this to required as well. And then we're going to go back and we're going to go to integration request. We scroll down, we see mapping templates, and we want to add a new mapping template whenever there are no templates defined. So we're going to add a mapping template that'll be for application / JSON content types. Click on the check mark and we get an empty input field here. Here we're going to write some JSON-like syntax, and we're essentially going to try and basically define whatever the event parameter will be inside of our Lambda function. So the keys will be minimum and maximum. And how we actually get the values for these from the URL parameter will be $input.params. We got parentheses and single quotes. I'm actually going to zoom in so you guys can see this still. We're going to type in the parameter we want, which is just happens to be the same name. And we're going to do the same thing down here. Input.params max. This will be in the video description if you want to go ahead and copy this. However, I suggest writing this out so you actually remember it better. So we can click on save. And if we scroll up and we go back, everything should be ready now. So we can go to actions, deploy API, and we can select our development stage, and we can click on deploy. Now we go over to the stages section on the left. If we expand right here, we see our get request, and we can copy this, open a new tab, and what we want to do is we want to set minimum to 10 and maximum to 20. If we run this, we should get a random number between those two points. So this seems to be working. Thanks for watching this AWS tutorial. If you need help or have a video request, be sure to leave a comment down below or ask in the Worn Off Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description. If you want to learn more about AWS, consider clicking on one of the videos you see on your screen now.